रोल नंबर 52, टर्न ऑफ योर कैमरा। ओके, इन द लास्ट सेशन वी सीन अबाउट द सोलर रेडिएशंस ऑन टिल्टेड सरफेस एंड सोलर रेडिएशन मेजरिंग डिवाइसेस, नीड फॉर द सोलर रेडिएशन मेजरिंग डिवाइसेस। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट सोलर रेडिएशन मेजरिंग डिवाइसेस। सो वी विल सी अबाउट द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द सोलर रेडिएशन मेजरिंग डिवाइसेस एंड हाउ इट एक्चुअली वर्क्स। So, what is the need for the solar radiation measuring devices? So, we can get analyze or we can understand how much solar radiations we will get from the sun, and according to that, we can manage our loads also, and we can analyze how much quantity of the solar panels should be installed. So, by using such type of devices, it is very easy to understand the calculate the ca various types of load and how much of capacity panel should be installed. So, solar radiation measuring devices. These measuring devices are categorized into two types. First one is the pyrheliometer, and another one is the pyranometer. So, in pyrheliometer is a device which measures only beam radiations. Beam radiations means what? Direct radiations. That radiations. That we are getting directly from the sun to the earth surface. They are not getting scattered anywhere. Such type of radiations are called as the beam radiation or direct radiations. In case of pyranometer, pyranometer can measure beam radiations also and direct radiation. Sorry, beam radiations also and diffuse radiations also. By using pyrheliometer, there are three types of the pyrheliometer: angstrom pyrheliometer, Abbot silver disc, and Epley pyrheliometer. So these three types of the pyrheliometer. These three types of the pyrheliometer will measure only beam radiations or direct radiations. And in case of pyranometer, there are again two types of Epley pyranometer and Elert solarimeter. So these two types of the pyranometer will measure both type of radiations. That means diffuse radiations we can measure from this device by using these devices. And in for total radiations. That are direct plus diffuse radiation. We can call it as insulation. Here you can see a pyrheliometer. Pyrheliometer measures the beam radiations of the sun. It uses the thermopile for measuring EMF difference. So, what is thermopile? So we will see a function of the thermopile. Thermopile is a one type of measuring devices that measures the EMF difference. So in the angstrom pyrheliometer, I will tell you the function of the thermopile. So here you can see one tube is located, and here in that tube, solar radiations that we are getting from the sun are directly getting inserted into this tube. So by using this type of the pyrheliometer, we can measure solar radiations. So for measuring the actual solar radiations or quantity of the solar radiations, thermopile measuring system is used. So here, these two types of the devices are shown here. The left one, this one is pyranometer, and this one is the pyrheliometer. Here both types of the devices are shown. So here we can measure diffuse radiations by using the pyranometer, and here direct radiations that we are getting from the sun are getting from pyrheliometer. So this is the acceptance angle that we are getting from the sun's radiations, glass window. From this window, these radiations are getting inserted into this tube, and this tube is too long here, and thermopile is used here. Thermopile is nothing but what? Here is the one end and here is the another end. One is the hot end and another one is the cold end. So hot end is of the sun's radiations and cold end is here, and that we are measuring the whatever the EMF difference is there, that we are measuring by using the thermopile system. So thermopile system is shown here. So first we will see problems of pyrheliometer. So which type of difficulty we can face by using pyrheliometer? Aperture angle, that means the direct radiations. We are getting such type of direct radiations. So we can measure up to 5 degrees angle. Apart from this, we can't measure the direct radiations. After that, circumsolar contribution. Circumsolar contributions is nothing but what? Whatever the scattering, radiations of scattering, because of that radiation, we are getting less intensity of the radiations. So circumsolar contributions is the another problem. And exact tracking option. Exact tracking option, we can measure tracking option, but exact tracking option is another one problem, because as per the time hour basis, the sun's location is getting changed. So because of the sun's location is getting changed, exact tracking option is very necessary to measure the exact solar radiations according to sun's location. So here First type is angstrom pyre heliometer. So in this type, you can see thermopile construction. So thermopile construction means what? Here is the point S1 and point S2. One is the hot end. Hot end is means what? S1. And cold end is means what? S2. Hot end, it consists of two metal strips, S1 and S2. These are the two ends of the metal strips, S1 and S2. So again, one of the strips, say S1, is focused directly to the sunlight to receive the solar energy. So at one end, that means the at point S1, we are getting solar radiations. These are the solar radiations you can see here. These are the solar radiations. After that, the second strip S2 is covered with a sheath M so that it is not focused to the sunlight. This is the cold end, and we have to keep this end colder. S2, we have to keep this end colder so that one sheath is covered on that S2 on that end, so that solar radiations will not focus on this end. Only solar radiation will focus on end S1. So then S1 strip will get heated to high temperature, whereas S2 is at low temperature. Because of the solar radiations, S1 end will get heated. This end will get heated because of the solar radiations, and S2 will not get heated. So how we have to calculate solar radiations? So we have to, because of this temperature, EMF is generated. EMF difference is generated between these two ends, S1 and S2. Because of this difference, we have this galvanometer will get deflected. Sometimes will get deflected here and there, where there may be differences. So because of this deflection, we will not get exact solar radiations. When we will get exact solar radiations? When both ends EMF is same. That means the temperature at both ends will same. जेव्हा ह्या दोन्ही साइडचा म्हणजे S1 पॉइंट आणि S2 पॉइंट ह्या दोन्ही पॉइंटचं ज्या वेळेस टेम्परेचर सेम येतं तेव्हा ते गॅल्वनोमीटरचे डिफ्लेक्शन बंद होतील आणि त्याचे जे लोकेशन आहे ते कॉन्स्टंट होईल. मग कॉन्स्टंट होण्यासाठी काय करावं लागेल? हा एंड तर हीटेड आहे ऑलरेडी सोलार रेडिएशन्समुळे, आणि S2 एंड, आता S2 एंड हा म्हणजे कशामुळे, म्हणजे इकडे EMF कसा जनरेट करायचा, तर आपण त्यासाठी काय केले, बॅटरी कनेक्ट केलेली S2 एंडला EMF जनरेट करण्यासाठी. तर EMF जनरेट करण्यासाठी ही बॅटरी कनेक्ट केली, पण आपल्याला कशाच्या प्रोपोर्शन मध्ये ते तर EMF जनरेट करायचंय, तर सोलार रेडिएशन S1 जे टेम्परेचर आहे त्याच्या एक्झॅक्ट येण्यासाठी गॅल्वनोमीटरचे जोपर्यंत डिफ्लेक्शन थांबत नाहीत और गॅल्वनोमीटर जेव्हा कॉन्स्टंट लोकेशनला येत नाही तोपर्यंत आपल्याला इथून काय करायचं, सप्लाय प्रोव्हाइड करायचं आहे. तर जोपर्यंत सप्लाय तो व्हॅरी कसा करायचा, तर तो सप्लाय व्हॅरी करण्यासाठी इथे एक रिओस्टॅट कनेक्ट केलेला आहे. सो दिस रिओस्टॅट, बाय युजिंग दिस रिओस्टॅट, एक रिक्वायर्ड अमाऊंट ऑफ करंट विल फ्लो थ्रू धिस सर्किट, अँड हिअर व्होल्टमीटर इज कनेक्टेड टू द मेजर वोल्टेज अँड अमीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन सिरीज टू मेजर द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू दिस सर्किट. सो बाय युजिंग सच टाइप ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन वी आर मेजरिंग सोलार रेडिएशन्स. सो So here is the one formula. That formula is HDN is equal to HDN is equal to KI square. So here HDN is nothing but the direct radiations from solar. So we have to measure that direct radiation. So we have, for that reason, we have to use this formula. And here I is nothing but the heating current that we are providing to point S2. To this point, we are providing I amount of current here. So that current is this I square, and K is constant, or dimension of the instrument. So by using this formula, we are measuring our solar radiations. For solar radiations, this formula should be used for calculating the beam radiations in the angstrom pyrheliometer. हा गॅलोनोमीटर कॉन्स्टंट डिफ्लेक्शन दाखवण्यासाठी कॉन्स्टंट पोझिशनला येण्यासाठी आपण काय करतो ह्या सर्किटमधून करंट प्रोव्हाइड करतो कुठं पॉइंट S2 ला. जोपर्यंत हा गॅलोनोमीटर कॉन्स्टंट पोझिशनला येत नाही तोपर्यंत आपण करंट प्रोव्हाइड करतो आणि करंट कशा थ्रू व्हॅरी करतो हा रिओस्टॅट थ्रू करंट व्हॅरी करतो. ज्यावेळेस गॅलोनोमीटर कॉन्स्टंट होईल ज्यावेळेस दोन्हीकडचं EMF डिफरन्स इक्वल होईल त्यावेळेस काय होणार आपण हा जो करंट मेजर केलेला आहे ॲमीटर थ्रू हा करंट काय लिहिणार इथं लिहिणार के इज HDN इज इक्वल टू के आय स्क्वेअर. बाय युझिंग दिस फॉर्म्युला वी कॅन कॅल्क्युलेट आवर सोलार रेडिएशन्स. सो द नेक्स्ट इज द अबॉट सिल्वर डिस्क पायर हेलोमीटर. अबॉट सिल्वर डिस्क पायर हेलोमीटर. सो दिस इंस्ट्रुमेंट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द मेजरिंग द सोलार रेडिएशन्स डायरेक्ट सोलार रेडिएशन्स और बीम सोलार रेडिएशन्स. So this instrument consists of black and silver disc D. This disc is here, you can see here. And mercury in glass thermometer. This is the thermometer for measuring the intensity or solar radiations. Suspended disc from block D. So here this is the suspended disc inside this block. Thermometer strip bent in U shape. So why this thermometer strip is bent in U shape? You have to just think because of when we connect such type of thermometer. So what are the solar radiations that are coming from here that will get heated? Because of these radiations, this tube will get heated and the mercury available in this thermometer will get heated. So for that reason, we connected this thermometer in such type. Here, perpendicular, this is connected in perpendicular, but again, it is connected in such a way to avoid the solar radiations or to avoid the heating effect. Collimator tube. Collimator is nothing but the instrument used for the measuring the solar radiation or heat. By using collimator, we can measure solar radiations and heating also. Three rotating shutters means what? These three rotating shutters. By using these are used for the closing and opening of the instrument. When we open these shutters, solar radiations will get directly inserted into this tube, and when we close this shutter, solar radiations will not get inserted into this tube. So for that reason, shutters are used, and we can vary our solar radiations, amount of solar radiations, by using this shutter opening or closing. So in case of about silver disc pyrheliometer, it consists of silver disc located at the lower end of a tube. Where it is located at the lower end of tube, here you can see at the lower end of the tube, that means the in here. My cursor is visible to you or not, I don't know. At the lower end of the tube, silver disc is located. कंटेनिंग अ डायफ्रॅम. डायफ्रॅम मीन्स व्हॉट? एक छोटे छोटेसे होल्स असतात, म्हणजे जसं डिस्ट्रीब्युशन पर्पजसाठी एअर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन टाईपमध्ये असतात, तशा टाईपमध्ये ते यूज केलेले असतात. दॅट सर्व्ह ॲज द रेडिएशन रिसिव्हर. डायफ्रॅम मीन्स व्हॉट? बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट सोलार रेडिएशन वी कॅन कलेक्ट सोलार रेडिएशन फॉर अ कॅलरीमीटर. कॅलरीमीटर मीन्स व्हॉट? द डिवाइस विच मेजर्स द सोलार रेडिएशन. रेडिएशन फॉलिंग ऑन द सिल्वर डिस्क इज पिरियडिकली इंटरसेप्टेड बाय मीन्स ऑफ शटर लोकेटेड इन द ट्यूब. व्हॉट एवर द सोलार रेडिएशन वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम द सन, दॅट मे बी इंटरसेप्टेड ऑर दॅट मे बी अवॉइडेड बाय दिस शटर. बिकॉज ऑफ द ओपनिंग ऑर क्लोजिंग ऑफ द शटर वी कॅन व्हेरी अवर सोलार रेडिएशन फॉलिंग ऑन द डिस्क. causing temperature fluctuations because of the this shutter, temperature fluctuations we are getting to the calorimeter that are proportional to the intensity of the radiations. Because of these fluctuations or because of this temperature we are calculating intensity of the radiations. Here for this device no formula is shown for calculating the intensity. We are just measuring intensity of the radiations upon temperature. This instrument is normally used as secondary instrument most of the USA. So third one is Epley pyroheliometer. So this instrument is also again used for the measuring the beam radiations or direct radiations. So about the construction of this Epley pyroheliometer, this device is used for the measuring the beam radiations. It consists of double walled brass tubes and removable quartz window. So double walled brass tubes are these tubes. These are the double walled brass tubes here. These are the double walled brass tubes. And this is quartz window. This window is shown here. This is quartz window and this is removable window. We can remove this window to get solar radiations inserted in this tube. So when we want to measure the solar radiations, we can open this window and that's sunlight radiations that we are getting from the sun will get in directly into this tube. And here heat sink is used or temperature compensating network is used here to measure the radiations. And we can here this dotted line is shown for the alignment purpose. And we can vary this end section, that means the heat sink, for the alignment purpose also. So here it consists of double walled brass tubes. So the metal used for the making these tubes are the brass tubes and removable quartz window. The tube is filled with dry air, is sealed with crystal window. This tube is filled with the dry air and crystal window is also used for the opening or closing. Temperature compensated by smooth silver thermopile is mounted at the one end of the brass tubes. This is the at the end of the brass tube means what? At the end of the heat sink, temperature compensated by smooth silver thermopile is mounted at one end of the brass tube. So this is about the pyroheliometer. So in the next session, we will see about the pyranometer, and in that pyranometer, we will see two types: Epley pyranometer and Elot solarimeter. So we will just revise again solar radiation measuring devices in solar radiation measuring devices, there are again two types, pyrheliometer and pyranometer. Pyrheliometer is used for the measuring the beam radiations, or another way we can call it as also direct radiation. And pyranometer. Pyranometer is used for the measuring the diffuse radiation. And when we have to say total radiations, for that total radiation we will say insulator. Insulator. It is not insulator. Insulator. Insulator word is used for the total radiation. Insulator. This insulator is nothing but what? Total radiations. This insulator is nothing but the total radiations. Pyrheliometer is used for measuring the beam radiations or direct radiations. This is the first point about the pyrheliometer. You must write in the examination, for measuring the direct radiation or beam radiation, we are using pyrheliometer. And about the pyranometer, we can measure direct radiations also and diffuse radiations also. So in pyrheliometer, how many types are there? Angstrom pyrheliometer, Abbot silver disc, and Epley pyrheliometer. And in pyranometer, Epley pyranometer and Elot solarimeter are the two types in the pyranometer.